Hi everyone, my name is Brian and I'm the 3D print creator, and in this video I'm going to show you why there is a limit to the thickness of things that you can cut with your diode laser. Lasers like the Orter Master or the Orter Master 2 or the Neijay Master series, they are made with diode lasers, and diode lasers are completely different from CO2 lasers. And well, this has everything to do with the curve that they have. But what the curve is, well, let me first explain that. Now, as you can see here, I have a piece of wood, and this piece of wood is 10 by 10 centimeters, or as you could call it, 100 by 100 millimeters. Now, what if I would divide this in the length into two apart pieces? Well, you would think that I would have one piece of 50 millimeters and the other piece of 50 millimeters. And this would be true if there wasn't some, well, some spill. But no saw is as good that it can saw without sawdust, and therefore some material is getting lost. So when I'm cutting in through this material, then some material will be gone and will be transferred into sawdust. Like here where I've done that, and well, you can see two lines, and those lines have a certain width. And the width of those lines, this is what is called the curve. So in this particular instance, it's a curve of 2 millimeters, because that's the thickness of my saw. And if you measure it, then you will see that it's 2 millimeters. Now, why is this important? Because if I want to make dimensional accurate things, then it won't be possible to get two parts that are 50 millimeters out of this material, because I only have 49 millimeters at one side and 49 millimeters at the other side. But for a diode laser, there is something more to know. A diode laser is a laser that is not perfectly round. And well, you might have seen this when you are working with your laser and you are focusing the line. And then you will see that when it's not in focus, you will project a line instead of a dot underneath your laser. And only when you are perfect in focus, then you will see that great and nice dot. Now, this has to do with the light source, and on a diode laser, this is some kind of LED. It's a diode, so a light emitting diode. Now, these diodes are not round, but rectangular in shape. And what happens? Well, it's represented here in this 3D print. So when the light hits the glass of the lens that you have underneath your laser, then you are going to focus it. And that focus point is where all the light comes together. And because that lens is a round lens, this rectangular surface that you have will be transferred into a round focus point. Now, of course, beneath that focus point, you will see that it starts to spread again. And therefore, you have to focus your laser into the center of the material that you want to cut to have the most power efficient cut. And as you can see here, it's going from wide to its focus point where it's perfectly round, and then to wide again. And yeah, this is why focusing your laser is so extremely important. Now, what you also see is the shape of the thing that I made. And because of this shape, which is also what's happening inside your laser isn't able to cut deep. If this would have been a straight line, then you could imagine that you could cut as deep as possible into materials. But because of this strange shape that I have over here, it's not possible to cut very deep into the material, because there where all the light gets in focus, all the heat will be transferred into the material that you are cutting. But there where it gets bigger and wider, there a lot of heat will be spread out over a huge surface, and therefore less warmth will be created. And well, if there is no heat, there is no possibility to transfer your material into ashes, because that's what you are doing when you are laser cutting. When you are cutting into wood, then you can imagine that when you're cutting this way, so the small side, then you will have a lot of energy transferred into the wood. But if you're cutting this way and you're not perfectly in focus, then, well, a lot of energy is going to be lost. And that's exactly what's happening and what I'm going to show you in this sample test. So here we are in Lightburn, the software that I use to connect my lasers to. And in this Lightburn software, I made these parts, which you can see over here, which are represented by a blue, a red, a green, and a yellow line. And these are the lines that are on the centerpiece. And all are cut with the same speed. So they're all cut with 600 millimeters per minute. So that's the speed I'm using with my laser. But the difference between those colored lines is that the blue line is done with 80% of its power. So 80% of the power of the laser is going to be used to cut this line. For the red one, it's only 60%. For the green one, it will only be 40%. And for the yellow one, it will only be 20% of the power. Then you will see that there is a black line. Well, this black line is to cut out this piece of material out of the wood so that I can show it to you. Now, let's take a look what happens when cutting this. You will see that the lens is perfectly in focus, although you can't see it really very good because, my air assist is a little bit in the way. But here you can see how it cuts into the material. And because this laser needs it, it doesn't have a lot of power, it is making every cut 5 times. As you can see, this is the 80% power line, this is the 60% power line, 40% power line, and this in the end is the 20% power line. And as you can see from the top, this is the top from which I projected the laser on it, they all look kind of the same. You can also see that this 100% cut was very well, because I was able to get it out very easy. And therefore, the 100% worked flawlessly. Now, what I want to show to you is what happens when I rotate the part. So when I rotate it, then you see that this is the 80% line, the 60%, and the 40%, and the 20%, well, it didn't make it through. Now, here you can see that the 80% line is perfect in this Y direction, but on the X direction, well, it's not true and true everywhere. The same goes for the 60% line, where, well, it didn't manage to get true and true for a lot of parts there. And with the 40% line, well, there isn't even any kind of damage in this axis. Now, not to mention the 20% line that didn't get through it all the way. But as you can see, there is a difference between this axis, the Y axis, and the X axis. And this has to do with the shape of the laser. So again, as you can imagine, when this laser, which I'm holding over here so you can see it better, is going in this direction, it won't do much damage, while in this direction, it will do more damage. Therefore, the curve of your laser, the line that it's cutting out of the material that you are cutting, it's determined by the shape of that laser. Imagine that you would have a saw that is cutting straight lines in this direction, but then when you would cut the other way around, that it's cutting in that direction. Then the thickness of your saw, well, it would prevent you from cutting. So now you know what this does, you also understand why thickness of your material is important. Because if you have thick material, like a 3 millimeter piece of wood, then only the center of this 3 millimeter piece of wood is perfectly in focus. 1.5 millimeters above and 1.5 millimeters below that, well, we're going to see that shape again. And well, this makes it in out of focus position for the part above and the part below the exact center of your material. And the thicker your material gets, well, the bigger your problem becomes. Like, for example, if I would hold this over here, well, you can see there is a gap. And only there where the gap is at its biggest, or when the laser light is at its smallest, only there all the power is going to be transferred into your material. Now, how thick is that line that you are cutting out with your laser? Well, we could say that in the most positive direction, the y direction, it's about 0.08 millimeters, depending, of course, on how your laser lens is focusing it. But with a standard lens, you could say that it's 0.08 millimeters at the exact focusing point. So if you're cutting, like for example, paper, then this is the truth. But the thicker your material gets, the more this is not true anymore because of its shape. And therefore, at a 3 millimeter thick material, we could already say that it's about 0.2 millimeters. So there is a lot of energy wasted in thickness. And 0.2 millimeters or 0.08 millimeters, well, that's a big difference. Now, I hope you learned what the curve of your laser is. I hope you also learned why this is important for knowing what kind of materials and what thicknesses of materials you are able to cut. And what's the difference between a diode laser, which has this problem, and a CO2 laser, which also has this problem, but yeah, it's way less than with a diode laser. And this is also the reason why a lot of power of your diode laser is lost, because you can have a very powerful LED light, a very powerful light source, but a lot of power is lost on the way from the light source to the lens, and then from the lens to its focus point and beneath that. So you will lose a whole lot of power in this path between the light source and there where you are cutting. There is a whole lot of loss, and therefore a 15 watt laser, which is 15 watt on the input size, it's going to transfer some heat in the LED. That's power that is lost. But then again, there is a whole lot of power lost before it hits the lens, and also after that lens. And a 15 watt laser in my case, maybe 5, maybe 4.5 watts of real actual power that I can use is going to be transferred into your material that you are going to cut. So this is how it works. Thanks for watching. Please give it a thumbs up if you like this video. Also, please, if you have questions, let them know in the comments down below. And make sure that you are subscribed to my channel and hit that notification bell as well, because then you will be notified every time I make a new video on 3D printing, laser cutting, that kind of things. Thanks for watching. See you guys later. Bye bye.